So today's session we will talk about the OSPF. Okay, so OSPF is not a easy topic as well as it's not a difficult topic. Okay, but it's okay. Interesting topic because in OSPF you can see so many types of the good features as compared to the another protocols. Okay, so first of all, let me tell you about the OSPF. OSPF is an open standard. Hello.
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. OSPF is an open shortest path first protocol. Okay. This is the Cisco protocol. Okay. See, last time we have already seen the protocols. In routing protocols, we can see there are the three types of the protocols. One is the static routing protocol.
Okay.
Second one is the default routing protocol. Correct. And the third one is the dynamic routing protocol.
Okay.
In dynamic routing also, there are the three types of the protocols. One is the distance vector routing protocol.
Okay.
The second one is the link state routing protocol.
Okay.
And the third one is the hybrid routing protocol.
Okay.
Okay. In distance vector routing protocol, we already seen the routing information protocol version 1 and the version 2, as well as the IGRP. Okay, IGRP. Yeah. Protocol nowadays no one using. Instead of the IGRP, people are using the hybrid protocol. So EHRP is a protocol.
Okay.
Before that it was a Cisco proprietary, but now EHRP is an open standard protocol. So nowadays people, they are using the EHRP protocol. Okay, because
it's called as a hybrid because of it is working with all protocol.
Correct. I'll tell you. See, hybrid in the sense what? Hybrid means the mixture of distance vector routing protocol as well as the link state routing protocol.
Okay.
Means some of the features, some of the properties in EHRP, which is similar as the distance vector routing protocol and link state routing protocol. As you can see in some books, they are mentioning EHRP as a distance vector routing protocol only. And the, in front of the distance vector routing protocol, they provided the one name, advanced. Advanced distance vector routing protocol. In some book they mention, they are not mentioning the hybrid routing protocol, they are mentioning the advanced distance vector routing protocol. So no need to confuse, both are the same.
Okay.
So now in LSRP, link state routing protocol, LSRP. In LSRP, OSPF is a protocol which is coming under the LSRP, as well as the ISIS protocol which is coming under the LSRP. So now our topic is the OSPF. So today we'll discuss about the OSPF and their features. So first of all, OSPF is a link state routing protocol. The second point is OSPF is an open standard protocol. Open standard protocol in the sense, suppose that if you have a Cisco routers, you can use the OSPF. If you have a HP router, still you can use the OSPF. If you have a any routers, like any company, it's not suppose that if it is Cisco is good, if it is not Cisco, another vendor devices, because nowadays market is not completely depend on the Cisco. They are using a different vendor devices also. Huawei also there. Huawei, they have a own router. HP, they have a own router. Even there are so many companies. Some companies we don't know the name also. Nowadays in market, as compared to the Cisco, so many competitors in the market. Cisco is always best. They are giving the best product, but appropriately, if I'm talking about the HP, Novell, and other companies, they are also providing the good router as well as the good solution. So all of the router, Cisco, OSPF, OSPF is an open standard protocol. Open standard protocol, it will work on the all router. Third one is a OSPF, which is working on the SPF algorithm. Shortest path first algorithm. What are the shortest path first algorithm? So this is the one kind of the features also. Whenever we'll do the practical, so that time you will understand the shortest path first algorithm, what is exactly that algorithm and how it's exactly work. In some book, they are mentioning the Dijkstra algorithm. D-I-J-K-S-T-R-A, Dijkstra algorithm. Dijkstra is like a name. Some, like, as you can see, like whenever we did the college or some education is like our school time, so we have seen the Newton law, correct? Newton's law. So Newton's is a person name who created this law, correct?
Okay.
Same as Digista is a person who created the OSP protocol. That's why they are providing the name of Digista algorithm.
Okay. Oh, really? Okay.
Yes. SFP as well as Digista, both are the same. SFP algorithm, you can say, as well as you can say, otherwise you can say the Digista algorithm, both are same.
Okay.
The fourth point is a classless routing protocol.
Okay.
Classless routing protocol in the sense, like we have seen the subnetting. Subnetting, you can understand the classless and the classful. The subnet, which is full, like suppose that if I'm using a class A network, so obviously subnet is 8. If I use in the class B, the subnet will come to the 16, the class C, the subnet will come to the 24. And if I'm talking about the classful network, okay, 8 is a classful, 16 is a classful, 24 is a classful. And suppose that if I want to full all of the subnets, so it will come around 32. Correct?
Okay.
So that is the full classful network. Instead of the classful, suppose that if any subnet is different, like any subnet is different, like slash CIDR value 9 is there, or here is 18. So still OSP will support. OSP is not like a routing information protocol one, because routing
information protocol. EIGRP, we cannot configure slash classless.
EIGRP, EIGRP, we can configure it classless.
Okay.
Okay, because EIGRP protocol is supportable. Okay.
Okay.
But if I'm talking about the routing information protocol version 1, classful routing protocol. He cannot support. He cannot understand what is the slash 9 value, what is the slash 18 value. He will understand only the slash 8 value, slash 16, slash 24, and slash 32. Okay. But if I'm talking about the version 2, RIP version 2, he will support the classless and classful both.
Okay. Okay.
The next point is point number 5. If I'm talking about the subnetting, so OSP is a protocol, he can support FLSM, fixed length subnet mask, VLSM, variable length subnet mask. The next one is a CIDR value, classless inter domain routing, like this slash value, also called as a CIDR value. Okay, this CIDR value. As well as the, we can do the manual summarization in OSP. Okay. In RIP, EIGRP also, we can do the auto summarization as well as the manual summarization. So same as another protocol, OSP also support FLSM, VLSM, CIDR, as well as the manual summarization. Okay. So these are the 5 points. So we'll talk about the next points. The next point is point number 6. Okay. So point number 6 is OSP always send incremental update.
Okay.
So let me tell you what is the incremental update.
Okay.
Suppose that if you are two routers, the router A and the router B is connected with each other. So just consider here is a one loop back and here is a one loop back. So this loop back network is 10.0.0.0 and here is network is 20.0.0.0. Okay. Suddenly, router is saying, I just want to create one more new network. So he said, let's create one new network, 11.0.0.0.
Okay.
Once he will advertise on his routing protocol. Suppose that if I'm running OSPF here, so obviously I have to advertise this network, because once I advertise, he will share his update to his neighbor router, correct?
Okay.
Right. So in that position, in that case, the new route is coming. Whenever new route is coming, so OSPF, what he will do, he will send only this entry, not this entry.
Okay.
He will send only the incremental updates. What your incremental updates, what your updates, what your routes is increment. Okay. That is the only information he will share. He will not share the remaining updates.
Okay.
Okay. So this is the incremental update. So now incremental update, we got it. Now we need to understand what are the hello times and the dead interval times. As you can see, every routing protocol, there is a, some time limits. If I'm talking about the routing information protocol, okay. So routing information protocol, what he used to do, he used to share all his update to to his neighbor router in every 30 seconds.
Yeah.
Suppose he is having the four routes. So he will send all four routes update to his neighbor router every 30 seconds. If is okay. there any changes, then okay. If it's then not having any changes, still he will share with his all updates to the neighbor router. Okay.
Okay.
This is like a big disadvantages. Okay. But in OSPF, there is not this kind of network. OSPF, he will share only the incremental updates. Whatever updates it will increase, that he will share only.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. The next, let me talk about the time. OSPF, he will share the hello packets in every 10 seconds. Every time, every 10 seconds, he will share the hello packets. Hello, I am router A. Hello, I am router A. Every 10 seconds. Same as router B, will do the same. Hello, I am router B. Hello, I am router B. Like this, they will say share there is a hello packets. Suppose that if the router has failed, this router, router A, suppose just consider, I will take the another color. Just consider router B, this particular router has failed. Okay, just because of some network issue, hardware issue, whatever issue it may become. Okay, just because of this, router B is not reachable towards router A. So router A, he will not remove his entry. He will wait for the first update. He will wait for the second update. He will wait for the third update. He will wait for the fourth update. So if he is not getting all updates, like his four update in 40 seconds, so he will consider this router as a dead router. Okay. So hello time is a 10 second and the dead time 40 seconds.
Okay.
So next point is update are sent by the multicast. OSPF routing protocol, routing information protocol, enhanced internet gateway routing protocol, or routing protocol, they are having the each multicast IP address. Okay, multicast IP address, with the help of multicast IP address, they are sending the hello packets. Okay, so what are the OSPF multicast IP address? OSPF is the only protocol which is having the two multicast IP address. So multicast IP address is 224.0.0.5. This is the OSPF first multicast IP address, and the another is 224.0.0.6 is the second IP address. So what are those IP address? How they are electing the DR and BDR concept? So there is a concept of the DR and BDR. Whenever I will teach you the DR and BDR concept, that time I will explain it the proper way. What are the how these two multicast IP address it will work in the future.
Okay.
The next one is OSPF metric, which is very important. OSPF metric is metric formula. I'm talking cost. Ten to the power 8 upon bandwidth in BPS. Okay, so 10 to the power 8 upon the bandwidth. There is some calculation when I will do the practical. So that time I will explain these things very proper way. How we need to configure OSPF bandwidth with the help OSPF metric calculation with the help of their formula. So in that case, I will tell you. Okay. So same as the next point is the administrative distance. Every routing protocol, they have an AD value. AD value is a trustworthy value. Okay. Some people they used to think AD is just a number. It's not a number. Yes, every routing protocol, there is some AD value. Suppose that if I'm talking about the static routing protocol, this AD value is 1. If I'm talking about the routing information protocol, AD value is 120. If I'm talking about the EIGRP, AD value is 90, as well as the 170 is for the extender. Okay, same as for OSPF, AD value is 110. Okay, now I'll tell you. Just consider I have two routers. There is a one link. Here is a one loopback 10.0.0.0, and here is another loopback 20.0.0.0. Okay, they are running a static routing protocol, routing information protocol, OSPF also, as well as the EIGRP also. Same as on the another router. This router also running the same protocol. Okay. So now, tell me what routing protocol. Suppose that if router A want to share some data to the router B, so which routing protocol he will use, and with the with help of which routing protocol he will share his data to the neighbor router. Okay, so in that situation, router one is having the four routing protocol. He will.
Okay.
He know he can able to send all his data with his four routing table, but he will use the routing protocol which is having a less AD value. Less AD value is the most trustworthy value. Now I am seeing the static routing protocol, his AD value is one. So this routing protocol, he will support the static routing protocol, not read OSPF and the EHRP.
Okay.
Suppose that if static routing protocol is not there, so there is an election between the EHRP, OSPF and the routing information protocol. So they will check whose AD value is the lowest. So they will find out, yes, EHRP is a protocol whose AD value is, internal AD value is 190. So he will support the EHRP protocol, not OSPF and the DIP. Okay. So always remember the router who is having the less AD value, he will always support the less AD value because it's a trustworthy.
Okay.
If I'm talking about the OSPF load balancing, OSPF can support the four equal cost of load balancing. Like OSPF is a protocol, he will support the four equal cost of the load balancing. Okay. OSPF will not support unequal cost of load balancing. If I'm talking about the EHRP protocol, EHRP is a protocol who is supporting the unequal cost of load balancing, but this feature is not coming under the OSPF protocol. OSPF only support the four equal cost of load balancing. Suppose that if we have more routes, still he will not support, as per the properties, as per the features, he will support the only four equal cost of load balancing. Equal, I am using this word. Okay, he's not supporting the unequal cost of the load balancing. That you have to understand. So these are the basic OSPF features. So I hope you got it. Tomorrow we'll do one thing. Tomorrow we'll do the OSPF stages. Okay, so I'll explain you what are the stages, what are the two-way, extract, exchange. Okay.
Thank you, Kandir. Thank you, Rahul. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Bye bye.
Okay.